Essential Books and Spoken Realms present You Are Your Own Best Teacher, sparking the curiosity, imagination, and intellect of tweens, by Claire Nader, narrated by Kitty Hendrix. A Beautiful Spark. If you are between the ages of 9 and 12, that is, if you're a tween, this book is for you. If you're a little younger or a little older, don't worry. You'll find much of value in these pages as well, as long as you're someone who wants to take greater charge of your own education and your own role in the world around you. What's so special, you may ask me, about the years between 9 and 12? In my experience, these are the years when you're at the peak of inspiration, idealism, and frank questioning. In my conversations over the years with kids in your age group, I'm always amazed at their imagination and their undiluted idealism about what the world should be like, but is not. At 9 or 10, you begin wondering why the world is so full of violence, pollution, racism, hunger, poverty, and disease, and why adults aren't doing something about these conditions, especially those which have known solutions. As you enter your teenage years, other concerns, desires, and diversions may start crowding out these priceless traits of imagination and idealism, unless you become more self-aware before you become a teenager. We adults need to encourage more of your pure imaginative idealism and your practical demands to fix problems. Your idealism is a beautiful spark that should fire us all up rather than be dismissed, as it too often is as a flight of childhood. Marianne Karas, who founded the well-received magazine Cricket in 1973, did not condescend to youngsters, instead providing them with regular serious fun for their expanding and imaginative minds. In 1982, she told the Baltimore Sun, "So many people talk down to children, but you have to respect their intelligence. Parents give them the best clothes, the best food, the best toys, when what they should be giving them is food for their little brains." Unlike Cricket and its founder, many adults may tell you that you're too young to understand complex issues, too young to be engaged in social activism, too young to make your voices heard. They may tell you that you have to wait until you're older. Greta Thunberg didn't wait. She was 9 when she began studying climate disruptions and the increasing damage they inflicted on communities all over the world. She collected the essential facts about the magnitude and frequency of these climate devastations: wildfires, droughts, floods, hurricanes, ice melts in the Arctic and Antarctic. And through cogent science-based arguments, she enlisted her parents and her sister to endorse her personal philosophy: to step lightly on this earth, our only home. In 2018, when she was 15, she began her Friday school strikes in front of the Swedish Parliament building to call for action on climate change. And the next year, addressing the United Nations, she demanded bluntly, "How dare you steal our future through inaction?" Her challenge resonated throughout the world. Felix Finkbinder didn't wait. In 2007, when he was 9, he was enthralled by Wangari Maathai, a Kenyan woman whose life work was to restore the forests of her country, earning her a Nobel Peace Prize in 2004. She founded the Green Belt Movement in 1977, enlisting poor women to plant tens of millions of trees at a cost of a few shillings per tree. Felix decided that he was going to make something similar happen in Germany and around the world. But his goal was 1 billion trees. 1 billion trees. He knew that the more trees we have, the fewer greenhouse gases are emitted to disrupt the planet's climate. He got to work, learning along the way. As he labored.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.